Are you afraid of dying?
What?
Do you wonder what happens?
Not really. A long ways from now. What would I be afraid of? And what?
What do you think happens?
I don't know. Something better than this.
An afterlife. I've never been to church.
Well, what do you think happens?
What if nothing else happens? What if it all just goes away? Every touch, every kiss, every argument and apology. What if none of it exists when there's nobody left to remember it?
Nobody knows. It's something much bigger than us.
Okay.
And your path became clear. I just wish you could understand what I'm trying to do for you.
I'm sorry.
You will. But your obedience is not optional. Fear not that which can harm the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, fear that which is able to kill both the body and soul in hell.
Why? Why are you doing this?
I had a brother. Guess I wasn't particularly fond of him. One day, we were hiking in the bluffs above the ocean, and at the highest point, he paused to look out. No one was there to see it. To see me shove him over the edge. You know what that felt like? Nothing. I killed my brother, and it felt so right. And that terrified me. I needed to know why God would make something like that feel so natural.
I don't understand.
In the Old Testament, there's a general by the name of Joram. He set out with an army to completely exterminate the Moab people living in the desert. In his haste, he didn't bring enough water. So Joram, hell-bent on the mass murder of his enemies, turns to the Lord, who surprisingly responds. He tells him and his army to dig. Fill the valley with holes and ditches. Offer a sacrifice, and God will fill these ditches with what they needed. Because the truth was, God has a need for them.
You told him you'd let me go.
I told him you would be saved. Just as he was saved. Just as God saves. He gave you his gifts for a reason, and that reason was not sin.
I didn't do anything wrong.
I killed my brother. It was a sin. I accept that. I used God's gifts for selfish reasons. And now I teach the lessons that most men don't have the stomach for. You can't change who you are. You can only change what you do with it. Time for your confession.
No, please. Wait. I'll confess. I'll do anything. Just tell me what it is.
It's simple. You tell me your sins, how you abused the gifts he gave you, And then you pay your penance.
Please. I'll do anything for you. For God.
You're showing me what a whore you've become.
What do you want from me? No! 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 No!
After all he did, just to give you a few more minutes of life. He understood his faults. He felt remorse for the twisted life that he was leading. Clearly, it was you feeding him the apple. You were the temptation all along. Fill this valley with ditches. And so, this tired and thirsty man began to dig, and toiled and struggled until they could do no more. They had done their part. The next morning, they offered a living sacrifice. And there was no rain or clouds or thunder, but the Lord filled those ditches with the water that they needed. And that same day, they purged the Moab people in a violent sea of blood and used violence for a higher purpose. God's purpose.
I don't know what I did wrong.
Please, I don't know what I did. Please, don't do this. Don't do this.
Needed him to be stronger. But he used you for sin. Do I kill you now? Deliver you to evil. I think that you need a true burden to bear.
Please, please, please don't do it. I don't know what I did. Please. I'm sorry. I'll do anything. Thank you. Thank you.
Your struggle will bring you closer. You have sinned. In your thoughts, in your actions. In what you've done, and what you failed to do. Remember that. Pray for forgiveness. And pray for a quick end to your mortal binds. Joram's army filled his valley in a day. How long do you think it'll take one man to do the same?
Why would I be nervous?
My family is going to love you.
father told me he loved me.
He was wrong. You're going to a real family now. And you're gonna see what life is supposed to be like.
He's the only family I've known.
You're better than him.
I'm half of him.
No. You're none of him. You're only you.
Where the fuck have you been? I told you to stay in the house.
Hey. I could really use your help right now. It's so cold. How am I supposed to do this without you? I was the weak one. Me. Michael? What is this? What is this? Michael? Yes, I promise I'm coming in. I promise. Please, I need to go.
Hello? Who's there?
Who the fuck is talking on my phone?
Who the fuck is this? Answer me!
It's Michael, sir. I was just talking with Amelia.
Who the fuck are you? Fuck you! I said, no phone calls. And no boys.
Go away.
No. No, 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 no. I told you, your penance is to keep quiet! Okay. Okay.
You know what?
Look at me. Look at me. Let me explain this to you in a way that you will understand. Do you see her?
Do you see her?
She's next. But she can be saved.
If you keep quiet and pay your penance like a good, true believer, then she can be saved. But if not, then I guess you two will just have to trade places. And you will get to watch. It's better. Drive all the way to California. Listen to me. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Stop it.
Yeah. He's still such a good person.
I'm not.
After everything, there's nothing bitter or angry in those eyes. How?
No.
I am those things. I'm all of it.
Hey, come here, no. Listen to me.
How?
You bury it. I bury it under something else.
We can go, we can get in my van, and we can drive all the way to California.
Was there to bury it with?
Hope. And you.
Mm-hmm.
Still hiding back here? I know you like the quiet. The nurses wouldn't mind their break room back, though.
They can have it.
It's been a while, Amelia. You're looking better, though. Do you think you want to talk about it? Maybe we can start from the basics. You know, if you're thirsty, you can take a sip.
Go on, the basics.
Okay. I know nothing about what you went through was basic. The problem is, I don't know what you exactly went through. I mean, we have your initial statement. He took us from the van, I survived, Michael didn't. But that's it. Looking through your records, we found that Michael must be Michael Pearson, registered owner of the van we found, also the owner of the blood we found on your body. We can talk about something different. I called your father up in Montana. Still no answer. We can talk about that later too, if you'd like. Look, all I want to know is, you come back here held up every day. You don't speak to anyone. Amelia, do you even want our help?
I said I'd get my own fucking water if I needed it. But they didn't listen. They always want to help. They want to help because then they own you. A man raises you after your mother dies. And suddenly you're his property, no questions asked. Boy saves you. You owe him your heart. God saves you. You owe him your soul. What if I don't want to give those things up? What if I take them back? Fuck this water.
I want to help.
I know. It's who you are. You can't change it.
Hey, honey.
Mm-hmm.
Honey? Who did this to you? Who did this? Wake up, wake up, wake up. Hello? Yes? I need an ambulance. Yes, my wife, she's been stabbed. She's been stabbed. I don't know. Please. I don't know. Just please send somebody. Yes. Yes, that's my address. Please. Please. Okay.
Look at her. Look at her. She had no idea, did she? You won't feel anything anymore. Just like I don't. I spent so long trying to hide my rage. But then you taught me the truth. My rage is